You're watching UNICEF television. Her labour well advanced, Trevini arrives at death's door with acute complications and dangerously high blood pressure. There's nothing they can do here. She's referred to a private hospital nearby, but she's sick before she reaches the taxi. It's a race against time. Two lives hang in the balance. Her family fears the expense of private care, but Trevini may not survive the long journey and added transport costs to get to a government facility. Here, she's stabilized and her baby's fine. Risks remain high, though. The strain is taking its toll. Her mother-in-law is a comfort. Not getting help in time leads to a high maternal mortality rate. In this part of India, Orissa state, up to 8 mothers die giving birth every day. Back at the health facility, another young mother battles the common killers here. She cannot lift her baby to breastfeed. Just 2 hours after her baby was born, she was about to be discharged, but she's found to be seriously anemic and suffering from malaria. Without medicine, she could die. There's no proof they're poor, so her husband must pay for his wife to live. Money is a killer. This is another. Transport, or lack of it, means too many mothers die giving birth. In this far-flung village, Purna's wife died tragically because she couldn't get to a clinic. Since then, baby Santosh and his brothers are cared for by his sister-in-law, who already had a family of her own. Another mouth to feed is a major struggle.
Since their mother is not there, the children are helpless and really feel her absence.
Reaching the unreached means forging firm ties.
First, we need people in the field with compassion. I think that is a key word. Because working in these conditions is extremely difficult. We need the frontline workers, the first army, to go and to reach those people. The second thing that we need is transport. Referral transport is extremely important. However, these roads are extremely difficult to go through. So we need people, we need transport, and we need a facility, equipped facility. Otherwise, the pregnant women will be referred from one facility to another facility, and it's a never-ending process up to the moment she dies.
Cash transfers to mothers to deliver in institutions and to be helped by a paid community health worker have added value to Indian mothers' lives.
Invariably, even the mother is very lean and thin. Most of the one or two ladies are very anemic. They have undergone CS operation, but if you see the child, they are all healthy. It is because of the care that has been taken during the time of pregnancy, you know, including this iron, folic acid supplementation, immunizations, regular weight, regular checking BP, everything, monitoring in a very good sense.
After an agonizing birth, Trevini has conquered complications and costs, paid this time by a donation. A healthy baby boy brings delight to all, and Trevini joins the ranks of the millions of heroes who battle against the odds to bring a new life into the world. This is Sarah Crowe in KHARIAR, Orissa State, India. Unite for children.